In the last AMA, we showed you how we'd installed our precision machining center to allow us to make the very first fuel spray nozzles for the GT50 prototype engines. While we were making these exquisitely small components, we found that the very last operation on the very last part that we needed to make to assemble the fuel spray nozzles had a slight defect with the tooling that we were using. So we'd had to modify the tooling to be able to get the last hole into the last part. That tooling's now here, so we're now able to essentially put the final hole in this component here, which forms the primary and the secondary orifices of the fuel spray nozzles. Now, the way that these work is your secondary nozzle is formed from a large hole in this outer piece. The primary nozzle then goes in and is fitted inside of that. And then the swirl chamber at the bottom of the primary nozzle is formed of this tiny piece, which has got some swirl grooves cut into it. That goes into the bottom of the internal chamber, and then it's pushed down under spring load by this internal pusher bar here. Okay, so it's a relatively complicated assembly, and every single dimension and every single surface finish on this stuff is critical. So the way we machine it and then the way that we measure it is really, really important, just to make the various faces seal properly together and then of course function properly together. Once we've got each of these precision components machined to a level that we're happy with, obviously the very next stage that we have to go through is to get each of these measured very accurately. We need to confirm that each of the critical fits is correct and that each of the critical surface finishes is correct to enable us to seal part to part to create the fluid dynamic properties inside the nozzle that we really need. To do that, we've used an advanced optical scanning method that allows us to see inside the components and measure every single detail and all of the surface finishes. And what we found from those measurements is that we're making all of these components to the required tolerances, and we're also hitting all of the required surface finishes that we need to make these work the way they need to. We've got a couple of very localized areas where we've got a couple of machining scratches and machining marks that we can tidy up in slightly improved machining methods. But what we've got here is good to go on the test rig. So with these new tools now in stock, this is the first op that puts the initial chamfer on. This is the pilot drill, and then this is the final drill that puts the 0.17 millimeter hole down the center for the primary nozzle. That's the nozzle that we use for starting the engine and getting a nice uniform startup around the combustor. So all of those are in. We're on with the production of these in 2 days' time once we've got the machine set up again. And in the meantime, Alex has been finishing off the commissioning and the calibration of the spray nozzle test rig upstairs. So let's nip up there and I'll show you what we can now do with that test rig. So here on the nozzle flow test bench, we've now got the gear pump under PLC control. We've also got the flow control valve here that sets the mass flow rate throughout the system under computer control. And we're also recording live data from the flow meter and the two pressure sensors that allows us to measure the pressure either side of the nozzle aperture to be able to record the full operating characteristic of each of the primary and secondary nozzles throughout the full operating range that we need for within the engine. All of that information is controlled and then stored digitally, including the flow visualization from within the flow tank that uses the laser sensors to optically measure the cone angle and then also the mean Salter diameter.